My presentation is Cure and Advance. I have told, and the next slides is aphorism 4. He is likewise a preserver of health if he knows the things which derange the health and cure the disease and how to remove them persons and health. Before aphorism 4, Master Hahnemann told about the aphorism 3, and thereafter he mentioned the aphorism 4, and before the causation of the diseases and the true knowledge of the disease. Why? My question is why? Because there are two things every homeopathic physician should know. One is the causas habilita tollita effectus. Other is the sine qua non. Causa sine qua non. Causa habilita tollita effectus may be a new term to us. It is the thing that if you remove the cause, automatically disease will be removed. And it is related to the aphorism 4. The knowledge of community medicine is first required for a physician before applying in medicine. Today we are seeing that a virus is a cause of the disease. That virus is producing different manifestation on the human economy. The virus is not our control. It is a natural in origin, might be in artificial origin as in Frankenstein. I do not know about it. But if you want to get rid of the sufferings of it, at present, as per the rule, as per the advisory, you should keep away from this, the things which cause the disease. So it is an agent. That agent may produce disease. So we have to maintain prima facie from this point of time, in this crucial point of time, the social distance, nothing else, and home quarantine, because this virus is ragging out, I do not know. But again, I will come, the sublata causa tollita effectus, there are so many causes. Prima facie, every physician should knowledge of it, should possess knowledge of them. They may come in the form of airborne disease, in the form of waterborne disease, in the form of vector-borne disease. We have to prevent it. How? By medicine? No. By the knowledge of community medicine, first of all. And thereafter, the question of therapeutics. Thereafter, the question of application of skillful application of knowledge of your medicine, therapeutics. So a homeopathic physician, one time you'll be a hygienist and also a therapeutician. This has been to you. Doctor, since after 2 days I'm passing stool. But why? But doctor, I don't know. I lose this very loose motion 2 to 3 times. But since before that, I did not have such type of symptoms. On inquiry, we find that the symptom is giving just like Nux Vomica or any other else or allocicrutina. But on inquiry, you find that the patient was originally from some village areas. For 2 days or 3 days came to some city for his studies or something else, drinking a water, impure water. That water is not pure one, not palatable one. And on inquiry, find that in this area, so many patients are also suffering and producing these symptoms. You may give some medicine. Obviously, that medicine may not affect. First, some patient you have given medicine, and that patient, the patient, no doctor, even taking your medicine, I'm not getting relief. But some patients are not getting medicine. Only they have advised them to please drink water by boil, or some areas where the water is pure water, drinkable water, palatable waters. And that patient already get rid of that problem. So this knowledge should we have required in order to remove that causes. Sometimes we forgotten that point of view. We should forget. Now here, the question commonly arises, why the question of vaccinations enter world are in question. What is the vaccine? What is the vaccine of this disease ragging around? The modern medicine, they're telling we do not have any vaccine. Please, the only the remedy at present time, please keep away from the disease. Keep away from the disease ragging around and maintain the advisory given by the government of India. One time, obviously, vaccine will come out in the form of herd immunity, whatever might be it, or in the form of any other methods as already adapted by USA or any other countries. Lot of billionaires are giving funds for developing the vaccines. in USA. I do not know whether the countries or any countries, though only they know whether it is a Frankenstein, they have already made the vaccine or not. But what is the scope of homeopathy here in relation to my subject, cure in advance? The cure in advance, as many Hahnemann stated in the aphorism number 56, footnote 6 edition of the 56 footnote, cure in advance. I here put the cure in advance. He mentioned as a past indefinite tense. I here put as a cure in advance in the present indefinite tense. 1790s is the birth year of homeopathy, as you know, and also another great personality, Edward Jenner, who discovered the smallpox vaccination. In the two happenings, Renisha happened in the medical world. Master Hahnemann discovered, rather published his article, A New Essay on New Principle for Ascertaining the Curative Powers of Drugs, and Professor Jenner. Master Hahnemann supported Professor Jenner, as you know. From the aphorism, as because I'm an academician, most of the students are listening to my lecture. Also the common people, common doctor also listening to my lecture. So about them, I can remind them that Master Hahnemann supported Professor Jenner in so many aphorisms I saw. You may go through these aphorisms, 56 footnote and 46 aphorism footnote, 6th edition. Six examples of law of similia. These are the examples, 56 examples of law of similia. Our master supported. What is told in the aphorism 6th edition 46? That seems to be the reason, that beneficial remarkable fact. Namely, the sense general distribution of the general cowpox vaccines. Human smallpox never again appeared epidemically or virulently 40 to 50 years back. Visited at least one city. The entire city devastated. Half or two-thirds of the children suffered and death due to miserable pestilence, as you know. Your master supported this one. So what is the role over here? Again, the question comes out. Again, in the 56 aphorisms, it told. They clearly told. What is the funny thing, my listener, my viewer, my audible, learned speakers? In academy, what is going on? When I used to teach, sir, 6th edition in my syllabus. When I was a student, I was to follow the 5th edition, 6th edition book. But now only 6th edition in syllabus. What do you do? And what do you tell? There is a great gulf of difference. Sir, we read the 6th edition, give the examination of 6th edition, but do not follow any back practice. What you say, but do not practice. It is a funny thing going on in the education. That should be looked up. That should be the matter of great concern for the educations. Here in the 6th edition, Master Hahnemann clearly stated that if the universal vaccination put an end to epidemics, that present generation does not know the consequences of that great smallpox wrecking around in the world. Yes, I do not know. You do not know. Even earlier generation do not know. But he told in the context of the isopathy. When isopathy people use the homeopathic medicine just by potentizations, in this support he told the similimum opposes is the similimum. In this context, Hahnemann, Master Hahnemann, submit an appeal to us that moreover in this way undoubtedly certain disease peculiar to the animals, but to animals may give us the remedies medicinal potencies. Yes, I saw very few days back when Gulf War was there, when the Casus Belli, when the aircraft went to the Afghanistan, at that time another disease broken out, and during that time and that people suffered, but that was not so much virulent, that's why not so much pandemic like this disease. Anthrax, you know, you can remember, but homeopathy did a lot for that time, anthrax, by giving us anthracenium medicines. In this context, my viewers, I want to quote the Winston Churchill. In order to establish our presentations, it is not my presentation, it is your presentation, because of the most of the viewers are homeopath of the different part of the world, that Winston says, more will go back and more we go forward. Really, we have a lot of history. We have a lot of events in the life of Master Hahnemann, in the life of so many teachers, as quoted by different authors just a few minutes back. They had did a good lot by giving homeopathic medicines. I am the witness, though I was in my childhood, I'm from the Bangladesh war. A lot of people came from West Bengal, from Bangladesh to West Bengal. And a epidemic occurred in that colony, in the different part of the West Bengal. Homeopathy did a good role by distributing homeopathic medicine, different stalwart, different learned physicians of the West Bengal distributed homeopathic medicine in particular areas of the Nodia and other districts. And government praises their contributions, really praises their contributions. Similarly, I quote that we have a lot of scope cure in advance. In this context, the questions of virulence is not there. Sometimes disease is conditional, already I've told earlier. It is conditional, sometimes disease is unconditional. Here is the disease is unconditional because the virulence is more. When the virulence of the agent supersedes of the immunity or the susceptibility of the patients, every person will attack, whether it is a king, queen, or any person. Stuart Close clearly says that there is no question when the medicine is when the selected in an epidemic by totality of the symptoms. Yes, we can gain, we can raise the immunity, we can raise the, so they are the stalwarts. We are facing a lot of tables to unifications because we have paucity of stalwarts. We do not have so many clinicians. We do not have Jain Kanjilal today. We do not have Bholanath Chakraborty today. We do not have Rastogi today. We do not have that Saxena today that can influence the President of India Parliament. Personally, I talked with the different persons in Maharashtra. Especially, I am calling from the Nagpur. Those who have very good contact with the Prime Minister, let us see and give scope to the homeopath because there is a stringent epidemic act is there. NDMA and SDMA, National Disasters Management and Epidemic, very stringent. So we have fight for that. We shall have to fight for that. That act should be amended further because that act was the British Act and subsequently amended. And subsequently re-amended by in the 2005. So there is a little scope. And another thing is that we have a very little number of physicians who are doing very good medical practice because we should have keep in remember that whether we unite or do not unite, that is a separate thing. Every decision taken by the politicians, the cost of SO, the cost of your articles, not decided by any association, not decided by any people. It is associated with the parliamentarian, so the political sense. So that point should be considered. The Grimmer, the Tyler, all of them, they did a lot. And also they are authorities, rovers. That similar, we have the susceptibilities. And this, we saw an articles that different advisor is given arsenic is the medicine for this point of time. Different papers and news. But in parliament, very close the parliamentarian, my parliamentarian is very close MP from Bengal. He raised a question over there that why they are giving and my honorable minister and retreat it. And yes, we have just the probable one. Yes, we have to face this one. We have scope. And if you treat, please think about the matter. The number of the affected person is what is the percentage in ratio to the total 130 crores people. How many persons are affected? Persons are in India. How many percentage will be 1%, not 1% today? Either they are keep away from that pestilence by following the aphorism 4 or some of they are also already attending homeopathic physician on their clinic. At first, government of Ayush circulated that nothing can be done by other alternative patches. Thereafter, Home Ministry has given a notice that yes, their hospitals will remain open, their manufacturing will remain open. I salute to them that given permission to distributing the homeopathic medicine. Personally, I talked with the one college of Calcutta, DN the homeopathic medicine, I also named that. His principal, yes, doing well, that some started a unit over there and also in Calcutta Homeopathy Medical College they have started. In Nagpur also they have been started different unit and they are treating the cases like influenza, like COVID-19, I've told you, don't name the COVID-19, just like Hahnemann, as you know, that Hahnemann always tell is a like malaria, like this, they're treating and recording. And then they might be the number, those who are not affected, in a majority cases, they need the numbers. So we have lot of scope. Don't be disheartened. Please do work because we are facing lot of troubles. That is the funny thing. Only the virus compelled to call to be united us. I just, that there are so many authorities from the profile against them, the common medicines I am quoting here from the slides, different authorities have given here. Now, cure in advance, that is a simple case I'd like to cite here. I don't like to name of the doctor. I do not to name of the patient. The patient was suffering from high rise of temperature, giving the typical feature of the bryonia, and patient was given bryonia 203 dose. After one day, the fever remission, the swelling of the parotid gland arisen. and the patient and the parents of the patient get feared and went to doctor. Doctor said what I told earlier, that you should report the medicines. It was a case of parotid gland inflammation, parotitis. Only the Brynia prevented it and went to SPD then in the referred the case to the gynecologist. And gynecologist and given the report, gave the report that it is a case of erosion of cervix. The patient told Dr. When I move, the bleeding started. And again, at that time, SPD was absent. His junior prescribed him nitric acid on that point of time, because erosion of cervix, you can call it, it is a gradation, obviously, a tumor from FSCA cancer in situ. Gave a nitric acid. But the nitric acid, he told doctor, pain is gone. My earlier doctor relieved my pain, but the bleeding is not so much. Not so much, but when I move again, bleeding started. Again, he went to see why SPD took the case exhaustively, going through the history of the chronic disease, and he prescribed cefepime to that patient. And after a few days, that patient came back. Doctor, I got relief. And SPD told, yes, that was the partial prescription. At the first, doctor was on the base was there. And next was the partial similarity. This is the totality. So even in these circumstances, we approach to the community. And obviously, the majority of the community is coming towards us and getting the relief by homeopathic medicine. Even in this situation, in the crucial period of time, unique. That means Hanneman told that every epidemic should be considered as an unit. In earlier epidemic, it might be a belladonna. In this epidemic, it might be arsenic or any other medicine according to the areas. The pandemic, the epidemic of China, the medicine, the acute disease is the individual type and acute disease are the collective type. The collective type is again divided into two. That is the epidemic and that another is the sporadic. Hanneman, it is the clinical classification. All the textbook and all the, so not textbook, all the marketly available books said it is a classification as two. No, classification is three, clavier two. Hanneman classified according to treatment. You please go through the sporadic treatment. That might be others. Any medicine may come until and unless we see the patients. But what is the cause that stringent act did not permit that? For treating. But in spite of that, the good people, lot of persons are treating epidemic, treating rather giving relief to the patients and patients. World Health Organization quite different today because they are binded by the rules. No authority, no man is authority. The rules, the principles are authority. So even in homeopathy, no doctor is an authority. Our principles, our organon is the authority. And we have to follow that organon. And we have to follow the stalwarts who have told about the epidemic diseases because they are clinicians. Today in homeopathy in India and also in abroad, what you see, there are maximum number of political persons or non-clinicians and non-epidemic. In private homeopathy medical college, I know, they're doing a lot. They're good number of. And some private homeopathy doctor teachers told, sir, please think over our matters. What will be our situations? Because the management will stop their salaries. They're not the salaries in this point of time. So management people, I should appeal to this consortium that you should think about their situations. Before the unifications, you should know that they are suffering. Number, there are 32 number of college. Dr. Subha Singh and myself, I am the pension holder. And having the good lucrative salaries of the government college. But there are more than 200 college in private college in the country. And their total number of patients in their custody is more than that of us. And they are giving good service. And there are more clinicians because of the good number of clinicians are doing practice in the rural areas and the urban areas. And they are facing because they cannot stop their chambers. They're regularly attending in their chamber. By telephone, we're giving appointments. Thankful to the government of India, they have permitted this one. In this context, the sinecure non as a not a new term is the indispensable cause of the disease. Indispensable cause of the disease is the miasmatic cause. If you treat, as I have quoted already, you have saw the template that if you treat constitutionally on the law of similar, even the immunity may increase in the immunity that. The large number of persons not affected till date may be rescued from this epidemic with the homeopathic treatment. Obviously, following the aphorism number form, aphorism number four, that the disease, the cause, that should be avoided. Social quarantine, everything should be maintained properly at that point of time. Causa occasional is, as I told, that causa occasional is or may come under the that cause that I have told earlier, that is the hygienic cause, causa sublitter tuliter effectus. That is not the real cause. That is the occasional cause of the disease. That promotes the disease, that maintains disease, but never produces disease in homeopathic parlance. Homeopathic parlance, but homeopathic philosophy, the belief of the miasmatic cause of the disease. The causa occasional is, in indisposition, as you know, aphorism number 7, that intelligent physician should remove it and the indisposition will soon coil upon. Master Hanuman has given so many examples of indispositions. Master Hanuman has given so many examples of organ medicine of prevention of disease. In aphorism 140, you know that 141 footnotes, the drug proving also give a protection to us. So we have a prevention of disease, of the acute diseases. Have acute disease in the form of treating the epidemic disease as per of organ medicines. The Jenas epidemic term, the particular term is not used by Hanuman in any part of the organ medicine. Though some part of the appendix chapter you can say Jenas like what. But some thereafter someone has, it is my question to the viewers and also the learned speakers, in which particular reference we call that Jenas epidemic, markedly available book. I don't like to mention that markedly available books, they are telling Jenas epidemics. But who is the pioneer which can be compared with the parallel to the Master Hanuman and Hering, who used the Jenas epidemics? But when I teach them, no, you should know the exact text what he told in the homeopathy. Similarly, in this position, sometimes we confused in these matters. You please go through the aphorism 7 footnote. He has given some examples over there that strong smelling flowers should be removed from it. The tight ligatures should be open, should be loosened in order to modifications. Small smelling flower, there are some persons getting affected by it. Some patients told doctor by hearing, by smelling this one, I get fainted. That should be removed. He has given some examples that open the imperforate anus and etc. Cross the vesicular calculus 200 years back. 300 years back, he told the cross the vesicular calculus in these positions and other and etc. He mentioned over there. Foreign body in the orifices, that should be removed immediately. They do not produce disease, but they produce the indisposition. In aphorism 150, also meant the indisposition. In the context of drug proving, he also mentioned the indisposition in footnote. That indisposition, artificial disease produces by drug proving. But in this context, the cross the vesicular calculus, open the
sir, we are running out of time already.
Okay. Just I would like to conclude you because an academicians, when I do these books, so my friends, the viewers, we have lot of scope to do it. Why the Stringent Act do not permit it, but those who are practicing in the clinics, in the hospitals, especially the private hospitals of the 200 hospitals in our country. And also there are hospitals in the abroad, in Pakistan and others. Please do and follow the homeopathy rule. Mind that no one is the authority, only the principles, only the rule, law is the authority. And our rule, our principle is organ medicine. Thank you to all.